God's nature is always to forgive and to show mercy. We humbly implore you for the servant Dan, whom you have called to journey to you, since he hoped and believed in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland and delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our readings, and let our reader come forward.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season, and a time for every manner under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to break down, and a time to build up. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to throw away. A time to tear, and a time to sow. A time to keep silence, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. What gain have workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time. Moreover, he has put a sense of past and future into their minds, that they cannot find out what God has done from beginning to the end. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the song, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want."
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He leads me in the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil.
don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus answered, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today I join with Father Brennan, Father Bill, Deacon Don, all of us here at the St. Francis Community in offering our deepest sympathies to Barb, to your fiancé Ken, and your son Bud, and wife Susie, and granddaughters Andrea, Carrie, and Tracy, and five great grandchildren. Our condolences from all of us on Dan's passing. We have gathered here today to remember Dan, and when we remember Dan, that person truly becomes present to us. Memory is a precious gift, but it also can be a two-edged sword, bittersweet, that gives us comfort, but on days like today, it is also very painful. When today we remember Dan in love, we invoke each other's spirits. The gospel that we have just heard talks of God's eternal home, and it is an image that we take comfort in today. After all, a home is an amazing place when we think about it. That a home, that is a place where we can truly belong, to have courage, to be ourselves with the people that love us, that know us. What gives this life the meaning is surely to keep supporting our faith, this eternal concept of the home that is waiting for us, and that gives us comfort today. Christ assures us in the gospel we have just heard that an eternal home is waiting for us when we die, and this heavenly home is his Father's house, and there are many rooms there for all of us. Every living thing searches for a home to rest, even the birds of the air. After they have spent the day flying all over and being busy about their lives, they eventually will fly home to their home. A home is not just its walls and ceilings, it is community and connection under the same roof, those who welcome us and accept us and love us. Today we gain comfort in our faith that this eternal home is waiting for us. As St. Augustine tells us, God has made us for this journey back to himself. That is how we are made. Our hearts yearn for this connection to come back home. Our faith tells us that our loved ones are not gone from us forever. They've only gone on their journey to our shared eternal home a little bit ahead of each of us. And they intercede for us in this eternal home in its endless rooms. And we will have faith today that we will see them again. May Christ now, we pray, claim Dan as his own in heaven. And may his soul and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
We'll now have our general intercessions, and I invite you to respond to these with, "Hear our prayer." Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. On baptism, then, receive the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Our brother Dan was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Family and friends of Dan seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Dan. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ. Grant them a place in the kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and he, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Anne, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into my room.
Thank you. Having received the sacrament of your only begotten Son, who was sacrificed for us, rose in glory, we humbly implore you, O Lord, for your departed servant, and that cleansed by the Paschal mysteries, he may glory in the gift of the resurrection come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May he ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Baptism, Dan shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May he be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. Sign of respect for our brother Dan, we let this incense rise to God who has called him to share his glory. Sign of God's